In this video, I am going to show you how you can export a Canvas course and then import it into another class at a different university or a different school. If this is our first time meeting, hi, I'm Ashlee Espinosa. I have an MFA in musical theater. I am a musical theater coach, director, educator, and here on my YouTube channel, I do videos for teachers, also actors and directors. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can export a class in Canvas and then import it into another class at a different university or a different school. If you teach at multiple schools or you're an adjunct professor, this is really going to be helpful for you because it's going to save you time and it's going to allow you to always have the classes that you've created ready to import when you teach that class again. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification so you don't miss any more videos. I've got new videos coming out every single week. Let me take you right into my computer so I can show you how you can quickly and easily export and import a Canvas class. So first thing you want to do, what is the class you want to export? Let's say I want to export this class from winter 2020. Go to the class, go to the very bottom, the settings in the bottom left-hand corner, click on settings, go to the right side and you want to export course content. So click on that. Now yours will not have these top ones because I've done this for a few other tutorials, practices, and I always make sure that I export my class at the end of every semester. This is a really helpful tip. Don't forget, at the very end of every single semester or quarter, or the end of every class, you want to export that file for your whole entire Canvas shell, like I'm showing you right now, and save it so you have a backup. If you teach at multiple different schools, oftentimes when they don't give you another contract for the next semester or the next year, they will deactivate your email or your account and you will not be able to log on to Canvas. So make sure you export every single class so you've got those files saved. You're going to click on the blue button, create export over there on the left. Now this bar is going to turn blue. It will not take very long, sometimes 20, 30 seconds, sometimes a minute. It really depends on the size of the file, how much information you have in that course. You can see mine already is done. Now this is the tricky part here. You want to go to new export. Yours will not have this again. It will just say new export. So click on new export. You can see that it then automatically downloads over here on the left side. It's going to download it directly to my computer. So when you hit new export, that means it's going to download that file that it's just created. Now if I go over here to my downloads, I can see right there the class is. Now keep in mind that this file is only accessible through Canvas. You cannot just open this file and view it like a PDF or a document. You have to put it into a Canvas shell to then see all of the information. So let's now import that class. Let's go over and let's say we want to import it into, we'll pick this one. So we're going to import into this class. Now, helpful tip here, number two, is to make sure that you import this Canvas shell into the new class you're going to use it for. First thing, don't create any other information to that class. When you get that shell and it's empty for the new class, first thing you do, import just like we're doing right now. So let's say it's going to be imported into this class. This will not be here. It'll be empty. Okay, so click on, again, I just clicked on settings, the bottom left-hand corner like we did before. Go to your right-hand side, click import course content now. Okay, at the very top, we want to pick the content type. You're going to click on Canvas Course Export Package. Now do note, there are other options here. Now note that you can import a Blackboard file. So if you've taught on Blackboard before and you've kept those files, you've exported them, you can actually upload them in here. It will reformat it somewhat, but it's a great way to, again, just start with the content you already created in that class. So let's click over here on Canvas Course Export Package. Then we're going to choose the source file. You can see right over here, I'm going to choose the file I've already exported just a second ago. We're going to click All Content. We want the entire class. Here's another option, another little tip for you. You can click on this button over here, which is an option to change and adjust the dates. I actually do this myself. I find it very helpful. If we click on Adjust Events and Due Dates, it's going to pop down here, and we're going to shift those dates to this new class schedule, so the new beginning of this semester, and then you're going to pick the new ending date of that semester. What it does, it's going to take the class before, if it was, let's say, a fall class, and now you're importing it into the same class, a new shell for the spring, It will then adjust the dates for you, and it helps you out because it starts to change all the due dates. So it saves you time, but you're gonna wanna make sure that you go back in and check it. But let me show you how to do this first. So you have a couple of options down here when it comes to adjusting the events and due dates. First off, you can shift the dates. So you can put the beginning date that it was, the class that you're importing right now, what it was, and then you can say you wanna change it to this date. So I would pick over here, this new class that I'm shifting to, the beginning date and the ending date. You can also tick remove dates entirely, and it will take out all of the due dates and the assignment dates, and then you can re-put them in from the beginning. I personally like to click shift dates. It's helpful for me. I find that it does save me some time. And then after you make your decision here, you want to click import. After you click import, it is then going to import all of that canvas into your new shell magically, saving you time. Then I want to remind you, this is tip like number four, remind you to go back in and review the entire shell just like you would if you're creating it. You're going to want to check all the due dates. You're going to want to go through the announcements and either delete or adjust them because it saves all the announcements, all the quizzes, exams, anything that you want to adjust that you want to update from last semester or the last time you used the class. And you definitely want to go through and make sure that everything still looks good, everything's still in line, your modules are still there, all the assignments are still there. It will not save any of the student information. So it won't save the roster, it won't save any of the student assignments, so those will all be not put in the class. Again, this is helpful because it starts you from a foundation of everything you created from your class versus starting all over. If this video was helpful for you, please click the like thumbs up button. Click the subscribe button if you don't want to miss any more videos in the future, and turn on that bell notification. It'll let you know when I've got a new video out ready for you. I hope this was helpful for you, and I will see you in the next video. Okay, bye.